In the year 2000, I moved from being in the corporate sector to becoming an entrepreneur with my first company, Customer Asset. Now, that was a huge turning point in multiple ways. One, of course, it gave me the opportunity to build businesses. And in the last 15 years, we've done many of those, and that's something very exciting that I've been able to do. But more importantly, it changed my own perception of what my own capabilities and the kind of impact that it is possible for me to make. So it was both a personal and a professional change that happened post 2000. So my entry into the healthcare sector is comparatively recent. In 2013 is when we started Portia, which is a healthcare services company. So I would not be able to comment on whether healthcare sector is very male dominated or not. For me, the journey in healthcare has been good. In the last couple of years, we've made huge strides in the business that we've built. Now, if I just go back to generally talking about is there a glass ceiling and what women can do to overcome that, I have a slightly different take on that. I think surely there are some sectors and certain roles where men gravitate more towards those roles than women do. But for the most part, what I found is that if women decide to take charge of their career and put their all in and make sure that they get the support that they need from the rest of the social system, it is indeed possible for them to go to great heights. We've seen that happen in many sectors, and probably India is the only country which has had even very, very senior women politicians, ranging from there to the financial services sector, to technology, to now in many startups. We do see women reaching the top, and a lot of that goes to how women take charge of their career. So healthcare is a sector where truly you have to combine your head and heart. Of course, you need excellent skills which help you manage patients' health conditions or manage large businesses in healthcare. So whichever way you, whichever dimension you come from, you need those skills. But truly you have to bring in not just the skills, but a lot of compassion, a lot of empathy. Because you do find people coming in with a lot of problems and you're trying to really help them sort their problems out. So for a healthcare executive to be truly successful, understanding what a patient is going through is super important, and not just the skills alone.
Especially within healthcare.
Interestingly, I would say that in the middle, junior to middle levels in healthcare, you see a lot of women. Perhaps it is, as is the case in all other industries, you see a huge drop off thereafter. And that is a problem across most sectors, that women in their late 20s and early 30s tend to take breaks, tend to drop off and maybe never come back and regain. Now there are multiple things that have to be done, both at the end of the company as well as at the end of the individual, to make sure that the women who either take breaks or need a little bit of slower pace are able to come back and continue and build a career at the pace at which they want thereafter. So women need to take charge of their careers, as I have said earlier, and make sure that when they are ready to come back, they come back with full enthusiasm, take the time that they had either taken a slower track or a break to rejuvenate themselves from their skills perspective so that they remain current, and when they come back, put their heart and soul into it to build their careers again. Equally, companies have to be very welcoming of women who may have taken a break, provide them opportunities to learn, provide them opportunities to come back and build their careers once again. The other part is, of course, for women to continue to remain in a company, they need to feel that the company really wants them there and wants to make them successful. There are a number of things that happen which are unsaid, which sometimes make it not worth the while for women to continue. It's not because they want to take time off, but because their time spent in the workplace may not be seen worth their while. So that's another thing that companies need to focus on and make sure that women feel wanted and welcomed in the company. Healthcare as an industry is ready for a number of disruptions. Disruptions using technology, disruptions in the way service gets delivered, disruptions in the way consumers can have better control over how they consume healthcare. Now, the opportunities are plenty. So whether it's a male or female, it's really about finding that niche, finding that gap in the system that you can build something around. So I would encourage women to look at healthcare with a lot of enthusiasm to see where they can make an impact. The other thing I feel that women as a gender tend to have a lot more of empathy and compassion. And healthcare as an industry, like I said earlier, needs a combination of skills as well as emotional quotient. So they probably can be very successful in the sector. If you look at the most deserving and probably the least served segment are the elderly and sick people, and they are the ones who probably have the highest challenge in getting access to healthcare. So how do we make healthcare more easily accessible to this population who is probably the most vulnerable, taking it to them at the time and place of their convenience, in a situation or in an environment that's better, best suited for them to heal? That is something that I think I'd like to see changing. The second is the way health treatments need to be delivered to individuals ideally needs to be extremely personalized. But doctors do struggle to be able to do that because of lack of data or lack of time to be able to personalize treatment plans for individuals. So how can we use technology, A, to give more time in the hands of the doctor, B, to help them personalize the treatments that they're delivering to the individuals? The third area is that there are doctors and nurses and other technical or other medical staff are always in short supply in India, and going to be the case all over the country. Challenges that's always going to remain in India is the lack of adequate medical resources, whether doctors, specialists, nurses, all of that are always in short supply. So what can we do such that we break down the tasks that they do into pieces that can be taken up by other not such highly skilled people, so that we are able to provide the doctors and nurses, the medical professional, more time to focus on the customers and on the patients? That would be the third area that I'd like changes to be seen.